Hey guys, welcome to today's video. Today, oh my gosh, I am so ready for this. I'm so excited. I have the new Maybelline Vinyl Ink Lip Products, lipsticks, the SuperStay Vinyl Ink, whatever, from Maybelline. I have all 10 shades of it. This product just sounds unique. It sounds like maybe I haven't tried a product quite like this before. So here's what it says about it. This is from the Ulta website. It says, shake up your long wear with Maybelline's Vinyl Ink Liquid Lip Color. This no-budge lip color lasts up to 16 hours with its color lock formula that defies smudging and transfer. Simply shake and swipe. Amazing. Okay, this sounds kind of like not quite a lip stain, not quite like a lacquer, not quite a matte liquid lipstick, but a kind of like all in between, all of the qualities of those products that we enjoy seems to be what this is. Maybe. I mean, we'll have to test it, of course. Like I said though, I have all 10 shades, darling. So let's just get into it. I'm pulling them all out right now. Actually, I'm gonna leave them in the bag and we'll just pull them out randomly. I think that would be more fun. Let me go ahead and take my current lipstick off. So I ordered these online, so I already expect that they're like new and unused, right? I did go ahead and like check all 10 of them though to make sure that none of them had been opened and used. These are particularly tricky though. So number one, you can see the sticker, it'll break when you turn it. So obviously if the sticker's not broken, that's a good sign. Some tricky trickster people though can peel back the sticker without breaking it. So just something to be aware of if you pick these up in store. Also on the inside, kind of like I showed y'all with their little Sensational Matte Liquid Lipsticks, I'll link that video if you wanna check it out. But as long as like the inside of that bit, so this one I have opened and swatched, which is why you can see all that product there. Okay, so this one has an unbroken sticker. I'm gonna turn it. There's product on the wand, you can see, but in the little top of the opening, there isn't anything there except for what I've already kind of smeared around. Anyways, hopefully that helps. Just buyer beware if you get these in the store or if you order them online. Frankly, I've ordered lipsticks from Walmart that they've sent me used. So just something to be aware of. And Maybelline, I still want better packaging. So one of them came like this. You see all the plastic that's on it? Let's do that, Maybelline. Let's do that for all of them everywhere. I'm just gonna kinda pick one out randomly. Ah, this one is called Cheeky. Now part of this is you gotta shake it. This looks like a gray color, doesn't it? Ooh, very pretty. What a lovely color. If I end up liking this product, this is one that I see myself reaching for quite a bit. Cheeky. This one's called Cheeky. How cute is that? It definitely has a sort of glossy, almost kind of balmy feel about it. It's not super thick, but it's not super thin either. It was super easy to apply. The applicator is really nice. It's already making me a little bit crazy with the sticky feel, like the, but that might be temporary. I feel it kind of like fading, like it's getting less sticky. So anyways, let's go ahead and take this one off and move on because I got 10 shades. Ah, this one's called Lippy. How appropriate. Oh, yeah. Oh, that looks like a really pretty color. Let's try. Ooh, super cute. This one's not quite as sticky. I am getting some initial like me stickiness. But yeah, this one's really pretty. This one's called Lippy. Two down, eight to go. I'm not giving it a lot of time to dry down. but it's definitely already resistant to coming off. Oh, we got a wrapped up one. This one is called Witty. Dang, this looks like a great color as well. Isn't that pretty? Ooh, I love this one. Ooh, very pretty. So far, they've all been very pigmented, very opaque, very easy to apply, a little bit on my teeth, no big deal. This is a great shade. I really like this shade, actually. Witty. This one's called Witty. Okay, it's going good so far. 7 to go. There's like a lot of red shades, so I'm kind of like, better pull out a red shade soon. Okay, this is kind of red. Ooh, this looks really like vampy and fun. Oh, this one's called Royal. This one's called Royal. Wow. Oh, I didn't shake it. Not used to shaking my lip products before putting them on. So this will be an adjustment perhaps, but. Okay, boom. Still super pretty. Okay, I was like super lazy putting that on. Don't judge me. So this is definitely like the deepest shade that I've tried so far. And this isn't just specific to this product. I find this happens a lot with like other deep shades. If you wipe the excess product off and start with a thin layer, it's not totally opaque, but you do get like good color down. But if you go in and add a little bit more, so like do some light layering of it, then you can get a deeper, richer color. I definitely didn't like concentrate and try as hard with this one, but it was a little bit trickier to apply. But this color is really pretty. Super duper pretty, deep, but still kind of bright red. Oh my gosh, I'm loving it. Okay. Oh, we got another wrapped up one. Oh my gosh, this looks like... This looks like a color that I should love. This one's called Koi. Love, love, love this kind of mauve-y pink color. So if the actual product looks like this, I should love this. I'm impressed with this shade so far. Usually, you know, there's some shades that I don't love. And maybe the other 5 will be terrible. Who knows? I haven't even swatched this one. Maybe this one will be terrible. I don't know. Looks very cool toned, almost kind of bubblegum. Maybe not quite the shade I was thinking it would be, but I love a cool tone pink, y'all know. No, that's super cute. I like this a lot. Definitely not what I would pick out like to wear with my eye look today. My eyes are a little bit warmer. I call for something a little bit warmer on the lips, but that's fine. This shade reminds me a lot of my Believe Beauty Honey Blush shade, which y'all know I'm obsessed with. I'd be interested to see how long the stickiness lasts. It's quite sticky. I think that it'll kind of like settle, like dry down slightly and be less sticky. But we're pretty sticky right now. But I love this color. Oh, I cheated. I looked. I'm thinking this one will probably look really good with my eyes. So we'll do this one last. Here's all the reds that I knew were in here. I'm gonna go to this one next. This one is called Unrivaled. Ooh. Very cute. Not super different from this one. I forgot what that one's called already. It's got a little more purpley tone to it than this one does. Very pretty. Yeah, it's not super duper different from Royal. Royal's definitely a little more red. Unrivaled's definitely a little bit purplier. Also, by the way, I really love these components. These components are really super nifty. They feel a little bit luxurious. Like, they feel nice. They're kind of big. They make noise when you shake them. 10 is a lot. 10 is a lot of shades. We've already done 6. We have 4 more. Whew. 10 is a lot. Okay, I'm gonna go to this one next. This one's called Wicked. Now, this one kind of looks like... Okay, so I mean, you can kind of see. Got some like more reddish brownish happening, some reddish pinkish red, red, red. Shake, 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 shake. I think this is the last like deep, 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 deep shade. Cool. So this one's kind of like your classic blue red type of red. Sorry, I don't have a flatter hand that you can see them all next to each other. So you will want to like layer this one a little bit. So this is like one kind of light layer. And then there's half of my bottom lip with the second layer, half without. Hopefully that helps. Because I find if I use a lot of product right off the bat, I'll make a mess, you know? And honestly, these applicators, so let me show you the applicator. These applicators hold a lot of product on them. So I'll pretty much just apply with one side and then like flip it over and do my second layer. These are getting on my teeth quite a bit. It's not a super big deal because that happens with a lot of lip products. And once they kind of dry down or settle in, however they end up being long wearing, hopefully it won't continue to do that. Really pretty red. This is a very classic, like blue red type of situation. Super pretty, loving it. Okay, we're getting there. We're getting there. Tres Más. This looks like a really super fun color. Oh my goodness. This one is called Capricious. Capricious. What does that even mean? I don't actually know. Capricious. Capricious. Capriciosus. Dang. This looks really fun. Ooh, look at that. Look at all the shine from the swatches too. This looks really fun. Let's try it. I like this shade. Oh my goodness, this is really pretty. This one's super nice. Even though it's so vivid, I did find it to be like adequately pigmented, adequately opaque. I did layer this one, but I didn't have to dip back in. I just, like I said, did one side of the wand, flipped it over, then did the other side. And it worked out smashingly, darling. Ooh, this one's really, really super fun. This one, I stan. Ooh, this one's super cute. I don't want to take it off. I don't want to take it off, but it really doesn't go with my eye look, so it's fine. I'm going to take it off. This one's also not quite as sticky as some of the others have felt right after putting them on. Super cute. This next one is called Red Hot. Looks like maybe an orangey type of red. There we go. This one seems a little bit thinner. So yeah, orangey kind of red. Looks really pretty. Kind of like the other reds, it's like slightly thinner, not quite as opaque. So I'm thinking I'm gonna probably layer this one, start with a light layer, then do another. Y'all know what layering means. I don't know why I'm over explaining so much. Ooh! Oh my gosh. I've never been much of an orangey red kind of person until like lately. I'm just loving an orange red. I think it actually works pretty decently with my eye makeup today too. This is so nice, so pretty. I will say the consistency of this one, Red Hot, it's quite a bit thinner And so I did have to layer it, and I did have to dip back in for this one, which is not a big deal. I'm just mentioning it because I really didn't have to for any of the other ones, which is kind of cool. I didn't find it particularly tricky to apply, so it doesn't like run or get away from you or anything like that. Gorgeous, really bright, really shiny. Loving it. And now for the final shade. This one's called Peachy. I think it's gonna work like perfectly with my eye look. And the components, I will say, have pretty accurately matched like the actual shade that's inside of it. So that's kind of cool, because sometimes the component will look like one color and then the actual product looks like a whole nother color, and that just is kind of annoying sometimes. Oh my gosh, cute. So all you warm nude fans out there, yeah, that's kind of fantastic, isn't it? Maybe a little bit lighter toned than I would have like picked out for the rest of my makeup today, but I think this works really, really nicely with the rest of my makeup. It works well enough, and I have tried on 10 different Maybelline lip products up to this point. Let me see if I can grab them all. And I don't really want to take off and put on another one, so we're gonna go with this. This is great. This one, Peachy, it's a little bit thicker than like the reds that I tried. Didn't find that I had to layer this one either. It's quite opaque, so it went down with just one nice swipe. Great shade that I definitely think I can get a lot of use out of. It's just kind of a warm peachy shade. It's just sort of a warm peachy nude type of shade. Now it's gonna be interesting to see if it dries down, how it dries down. Oh, you know what? Let's look at the swatches, because was it these up here that I started with? Okay, so these still feel kind of sticky on the swatch a little bit, but I'm not getting any like product coming up, which is interesting. Maybe a little bit from that one, that was that deep red swatch. Oh. That's kind of interesting. It's like not smearing. Try this one. Maybe a little bit there. What? That's wild. Let me wipe my hand off a little bit. What? Maybe a little comes off. Dude, what? What in the world? Okay, little came off on that too. Just a little bit. That's kind of crazy. Well, based on that, this ought to wear well. So I'll go ahead and put my little wear test results in right now. What's up? So I've had the lipstick on for a few hours now, and I am happy to report that the sticky feeling does go away. It's definitely not bothering me anymore. It does maintain like a little bit of a slip, like a little bit of creaminess, not a lot. It almost feels like you put a lip balm on like a few hours ago and it's like almost gone, that kind of feeling. But obviously there's still product on my lips and it's still pretty opaque. It's not like faded or anything like that. I just wanted to do this check-in before I ate so that y'all could see kind of what it looks like. I've had like a little bit to drink and I've had like some snacks. So I've eaten and drank a little bit and it transfers like slightly, like a little bit. Let's see if it, oh, okay. So some of it came off there. Some of it came off there too. So it transfers a little bit, not too bad. If the color holds up and like the opacity and all of that, I'm expecting it'll be gone after I eat. I'm pretty much expecting it'll be gone after I eat, but we'll see. I will be back in a little bit to see how it goes. Say hi, Miller. Say hi, baby. He's my papa. He wants his dinner. He's like, see, he's like very frustrated with me, but I actually have to go to the grocery store and get it. So I'm gonna go do that. Alrighty, folks. It is now the end of the day, and I'm ready to take my makeup off. So here's what's left. Here's what's left of the swatches. I just tried taking these off with a makeup wipe earlier, and that's about how it went. And then here is my mouth. So they definitely like stain a little bit, which I think helps with the long wearedness of it. It's pretty much almost all gone now. Like there's some, you know, still on the outsides of my lips, but like I ate a salad with some balsamic vinaigrette. So it was like kind of oily dressing. So like I said, I fully expected it to be gone after I ate. And yeah, I mean, I'm really happy with how it wore otherwise. The only thing was at one point I got like a little fuzz or something on my lip. Now I have hair in my mouth too somehow. But I did get a little bit of like fuzz on my lips, and it was hard to get it off because I was like wiping. I just like, I don't know, because it maintains like a little bit of a slip, I just kind of felt like I couldn't get the fuzz off. Like I wasn't sure if it had come off. So that was kind of maddening, not gonna lie. Otherwise, it was super comfortable. I kind of like that it gives that little bit of a balmy feel without actually, you know, just smearing everywhere. Like it stays in place after you give it a little bit of time to settle in. I won't say dry down because it doesn't really dry down. Like I said, it still maintains that slip. It's just really interesting, and I don't really have any other lip products quite like it. And I'm just super happy with the shades. I'm super happy with how it wore, how comfortable it was. So I'm really excited to try the rest of these out. Let me know what you guys think. Are y'all gonna try the Maybelline SuperStay Vinyl Ink Lipsticks? Also the Sensational Matte Lips that are at Dollar General are fantastic. So Maybelline is killing it with the lipstick game lately. Anyways, drop me a comment, say hello. I always love hearing from you guys, and I really hope that you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Okay, bye.